Scheherazade. In this chapter, we shall read how a prince got his true love.
Once upon a time, a king lived on the island of Kaledan. His subjects loved him so much and his enemies also respected him. His life was not always happy. After years of marriage, he had no children. However, at long last, one splendid spring morning, a handsome baby boy was born and his delighted parents called him Omar. This means shining light. The years went by and Omar grew into a fine-looking youth, brave, intelligent and kind-hearted. On his 18th birthday, the king sent for his son. Omar, now that you have come of age, you must find a wife. Choose one of the wife princes you have met and whose only dream is of marrying you. Father, said Omar respectfully, I have no intention of getting married. I am still young. Omar, you must stop wasting time. You are a grown man now and I want to see your heirs. I'm sorry, father. I can't do that just yet. I'm not in love and so I can't get married. The king shouted for the guards and ordered them to shut the prince in an old castle in the forest. In the meantime, lovely, sweet-natured
Princess Scheherazade was a maiden whose home was in China. When she turned 16, her father insisted her to marry. But Scheherazade was waiting to meet a true love.
And since nothing the king, her father did serve to change her mind, he locked the princess up in one of the palaces. Meantime, Omar spent lonely sad days in the castle where he was held prisoner. However, two invisible genies, Abu and Dabi, were amusing themselves, unknown to the prince, by secretly watching his movements. One day, Abu said to his friend, Omar is the most handsome person in the whole world. Not so, exclaimed Dabi. The most beautiful person in
the world is Scheherazade, the king of China's daughter. The genies started to argue
and then decided to ask Lilibet, the daughter of the genie king, to judge the matter. Lilibet's advice was this: go to China, cast a sleeping spell over the princess and bring her to Omar's castle. When you see them together, then you will soon see who is more beautiful. That very night, Abu and Dabi flew all the way to China. The two genies sent the princess to sleep and carried her to Omar's castle.
Not long afterwards, Scheherazade opened her eyes and
when she saw Omar at her side, her heart began to thump. This was the man she would like to marry. So she took off one of her rings and slipped it onto his finger as a token of love. Then she went back to sleep. On awakening a little later,
Omar set eyes on Scheherazade and was overwhelmed by her beauty.
If this girl is as kind as she is beautiful, she would make a wonderful wife, said Omar to himself as he gazed at her in amazement. Then he took off a ruby ring and slipped it onto the prince's finger and he fell asleep. Abu and Dabi crept out from behind the curtain wide-eyed. They have fallen in love, said Dabi. What are we to do now?
Take Scheherazade home again.
But if they have really fallen in love, they will move heaven
and earth to meet again.
When Omar awoke, he did not find the girl there and asked the guard, but all in vain. The king told Omar, my lad, you are losing your head over a girl you dreamed about. No, she was not a dream.
The prince insisted.
This is the ring she left me. Omar was lovesick. The king called doctors and wise men, but there was nothing they could do. And
far away, Scheherazade was also suffering with same pain.
The only person who believed the princess was Maruzwan, a childhood friend, and she offered to search for the missing youth.
Scheherazade handed him Omar's ruby ring.
Maruzwan set out that same day, and with great difficulty she reached the island of Kaledan. She asked the stranger, where am I? On the island of Kaledan, replied the stranger, who are you? I am a doctor and famous in my own land. I heard that the prince is seriously ill. I would like to try and cure him. The stranger took her in the palace. Without saying a word, Maruzan showed him the ruby ring. Omar uttered a shriek and leapt to his feet. The onlookers stared in surprise. This is the ring I gave to the girl. I want to marry him, the prince exclaimed joyfully.
That young lady is Scheherazade.
She lives in far off China and is dying to see you again. Maruzwan told him instantly. Omar was delighted. In finding the girl of his dreams, he would be truly happy. He presented Maruzwan with a jeweled sword and a splendid horse as fast as the wind as a token of thanks.
Omar and Scheherazade quickly asked the king's permission
to get married as soon as possible. Lilibet said, well, I would say they are the best looking couple in the world, Abu and Dhabi, and I'm certain their children will be even more handsome. And so the argument finally ended to everybody's satisfaction and the two genies hugged each other contentedly.